Biafra miracle. I came all the way from Ibibio to celebrate my director. I came all the way from Akwa Ibom to celebrate my director. And right now in the rally of Donald Trump, the zoo army and the zoo DSS. If you look at my back, the DSS are there. If you go to the front,
these are members of the indigenous people of Biafra. They have converged on Port Harcourt from different states in the southeast and south-south. For them, the coming on board of the U.S. President Donald Trump brings a sign of relief for their struggle in having their own sovereign states. But their expectations were cut short when the military arrived at the location and blocked the road with trucks, preventing them from accessing Port Harcourt City.
So many people have sustained a very big injury. We have like two people, one woman and two other men that sustained a heavy injury, and they cannot walk right now. One of them, army soldier, flogged her, and they pushed her on that valley that led to Oruoruku village. And if you see the way the woman tumbled, if you can look at me, almost all of us, what I put on here is white, because what we are celebrating, what we are doing is just a rally. We are not even protesting. We are doing rally in recognition of Donald Trump's way in.
Some members of the indigenous people of Biafra, mostly women and youths, were injured with various degrees of bullet injuries and bruises when the soldiers opened fire to disperse the procession.
As we are marching coming, so we now saw some people that is running. Well, we refused to run because we are not making any problem to anybody to Zoom. So we just stand. As we stand, they now rushed and meet us there, started to beat us. One of them kicked me on my leg. Then this leg now, and I have dislocation. And they collected my phone, everything, even the bag I had, they collected it.
Traffic and normal commercial activities were paralyzed between water lines and garrison axes of Aba Road, Port Harcourt, during the military operation to stop the rally.